Sebring is a still, small town with a quiet rhythm of its own, where people relax comfortably the whole year round in the Florida sun. Almost the whole year round, that is. Once a year in March, the tempo picks up. The town plays host to one of the most colorful events anywhere. Of the year, the quiet of Sebring and this abandoned military airfield just outside the town will be shattered. That week is about to begin. Sounds and in shapes and forms unique to any but a racing capital, over 50,000 fans, spectators, and participants converge on this small town for the Sebring 12-hour International Grand Prix of Endurance. Short days since the first sports car gunned its way through the town is changed. And the excitement of things to come splinters into colorful fragments of cars and people around its hub. There are people in a hurry and guys who have all the time in the world. And so, for everyone, Sebring, in Race Week, is the place to be. If you can find a place to stay. 65 of the finest cars made anywhere in the world come to Sebring by invitation only, to be tested here in the biggest challenge for sports cars on the American continent. The hangars still bordering the airport become garages. Mechanics wanting no part of sun and having no time for relaxation get down to work. They set up shop, pull out and set down their tools, the instruments of their profession. These are the wizards with wrenches who perform for the age of the machine. Time for adjustment and tuning and readjusting is done. Cars must pass official inspection. Lady spectators, but this is no special ladies' day. At Sebring, women are part of the crews, and some will race for the same reasons and the same odds as men. Just that. Every competition car must meet the technical requirements. They must be set up with the same components and characteristics of any sports car that would be used by the public on regular roads. When the machine checks out, there's still the big question. What will it do on the track? There's only one way to find out. race morning. The big day has come. Hours before starting time, the fans pour into the airport and race areas. Moment that is Sebring is almost here. All the training, conditioning, inventing, planning will end in 12 hours with heartbreak for some and triumph for others. Only the best race at Sebring, and the starting field includes drivers from around the world. Scotland, Belgium, Germany, Canada, France, Switzerland, Sweden, Holland, England, Iceland, Italy, South Africa, Argentina, Mexico, New Zealand, Puerto Rico, and the United States. They're going to find out who's who and what's what.
Thank you.
pit stops begin. Cars pit for fuel, tires, repairs, and a change of drivers. Compounded with tension and frustration. Each car has a team of two drivers who spell each other over a long, grinding day. The drivers on the course. The spectators show their own kind of endurance, impatient and idle waiting from dawn to night. This dedicated standing by on the part of race fans is found in few other sports. Dusk, and another hazard begins as the dwindling light and growing shadows play tricks on the twisting course. The battle against the clock seems never ending. The vicious pace begins to show on machines, on men, and on nerves. In international endurance racing, pit stops can be demonstrations of inspired madness. Things that have been working for hours suddenly become inoperative. Various metal parts become inexplicably red hot, and all bolts reverse their threads. The crews respond with activity that is a kind of explosion of colorful incomprehensibility. those last grinding hours when everything is wearing out and the strong are pressing and the fading are trying to hold, then is when this Grand Prix of endurance begins to have a quality all of its own. Hour and the minutes leap past. Someone fades out in the darkness, and someone else springs out from the flashing lights to win. And a new winner joins the ranks of the greats at Sebring. The airport that beat to new and strange rhythms is quiet again. Sebring and those who were just passing through, both somewhat out of breath, settle back to being themselves again. Until next year.